Hey everyone, and welcome back to another upload. Probably not what you expected, huh? Well, I'll let you all in on a fun fact about myself. I'm a huge fan of lost media. It doesn't even have to be the media itself, but watching people come together to uncover something that's significant to them for the whole world to see is just so astounding. I'm sure everyone has that one thing they hold close to them that they can't seem to find anymore. And today, I wanted to share one of those things with you. I can't exactly remember how this thing came to mind after not thinking about it for years, but I somehow managed to recall a webcomic series by the name of Polygoons. Does that ring a bell to any of you watching? Well, if it doesn't, allow me to tell you about it. Polygoons is an Instagram webcomic that was created on June 14, 2017. The webcomic followed the lives of Square Guy and Triangle Man, two roommates who live in a world of aforementioned polygoons. At least, that's how the webcomic started. As the series progressed, we'd be introduced to more characters who would have a greater role later on, such as Dave Diamond and Mr. Pentagon, two extras who originally made an appearance for a single comic. Of course, many other minor characters would be introduced, but their inclusion makes the most sense in the context of the webcomic's many storylines. So let's go over them.
From humble beginnings.
Pages 1 to 12 of Polygoons are pretty standard for a webcomic. I don't mean that in a judgmental way, of course, but it accomplishes what you'd expect from the start of a series. It establishes Square Guy as a level-headed everyman, and Triangle Man as a dumb but ultimately harmless goofball. Two very simple characters that can be worked into a lot of stories. These first 12 pages also establish the webcomic's sense of humor, which is pretty lighthearted but charming at the very least. As I mentioned before, eventual mainstay characters such as Dave Diamond and Mr. Pentagon are introduced early without much character, apart from Guy at Party and Prisoner. And then there's Baby Blue, which is a pretty good name, to be honest. Apart from the fact that he isn't even Baby Blue, but that's besides the matter. Page 11 brings back Mr. Pentagon, who establishes himself as the comic's villain, and in page 12, he kills Square Guy and Triangle Man. I never really understood the motive for this, apart from bad guy does bad thing, and when we get the build-up to this moment later in the comic, I think it makes even less sense, but look, there's Dave Diamond again. And this page leads us to the comic's first arc. Polygoals is the first arc of Polygoons, which began on August 23rd, 2017. The arc continues from page 12, with Mr. Pentagon killing Square Guy and Triangle Man, and follows the misadventures of the two as ghouls, with them eventually wanting to get their bodies back. They find Mr. Pentagon, who's weirdly cool with helping them, and hijinks ensue. Things seem like a lost cause, convenient solution. The end. And as the comic's first arc, it's not bad. Mind you, this arc was right around the beginning of the comic's lifespan, so while the story is simple, it's a quick, enjoyable read.
It is a little something for everyone.
It is kind of weird how much Mr. Pentagon flipped as a character after the prologue, but I also find it funny how he dropped off as the comic's villain after performing two debatably villainous acts. After Polygoals, things continued back at their usual pace. Like with Mr. Pentagon, there were some slight changes in the characters of Square Guy and Triangle Man. Square Guy was made out to be a bit more narcissistic, and I think some of his sarcasm and occasional smugness began to rub off on Triangle Man, but Triangle Man was still as goofy as before. And Mr. Pentagon and Dave Diamond began to get more appearances in the pages, establishing a sort of friendship that was teased back in page 12. However, most importantly, this period in the series' lifespan was the introduction of new characters. Long Arms Johnson and I believe Trapezoid Woman made their first appearances during this batch of comics. But the standouts were the winners of the Polygoons fan-made character contest, those being Oval Dude Guy, Dr. Cross, and of course Infinite. These characters became fairly important side characters in the Polygoon series, on top of being given their own debut comics. 27 for Oval Dude Guy, 38 for Dr. Cross, and somewhere within the next arc for Infinite. Oh wait, I'm getting ahead of myself. Waste of Space is the second arc of Polygoons, which was set to release February 2018. However, this is where things start to get foggy in the Polygoon storyline, because most of this arc has been lost to time. Even after going through the archive and doing my own digging, I haven't been able to find out what page this arc began and how the plot even started. But with what little we have, I could explain what seems to be the middle and the end. So, Square Guy and Triangle Man end up in space somehow. They want to get back home, and they meet up with Infinite, who I brought up earlier. Infinite gives them one wish each, and now I'm relying on a mix of my memory and the few single panels that remain. Square Guy wishes to go home, while Triangle Man uses his wish for quote-unquote the greater good. Taken aback, Square Guy is sent back home without Triangle Man. At least, that's what it seems, until Triangle Man appears behind Square Guy, holding a jar. Square Guy picks up the pieces, realizing that Triangle Man meant a jar of M&Ms when he was referring to quote-unquote the greater good. Triangle Man reveals it was actually a jar of Skittles, and Square Guy breaks the jar. Arc over. Yeah, this one's a bit rough. I appreciate how this arc tried to get the reader more emotionally invested in the story more than in Polygools, while not being too sad or sappy. But it's difficult to feel anything too strong when only two pages have been archived. That's obviously not the artist's fault, but it's harder to critique this way. I think Infinite has an interesting character concept, and I like that the friendship between Square Guy and Triangle Man is given more weight, but that honestly makes the ending hit less for me. And the ending is already a hit or miss. Maybe the full arc is better than I remember, but as of right now, I think Polygools is still up top. After Waste of Space, things were starting to look better for Polygoons. For starters, Polygoons comics were starting to go viral on Instagram, such as the Roses Are Red comic, the Missing Two Vital Organs comic, the Internet Celebrity comic, the Local Idiot Sells Apartment for Sandwich comic, and the Lost comic, which I think actually came out later on. Whether from meme accounts, or those shitty Instagram comic repost pages, Polygoons started to attract a greater following both unironically and ironically. But with growth came slight changes in the webcomic. For one, Triangle Man started to become the main focus of comics over Square Guy, although their characters remain mostly the same. Meanwhile, side characters such as Dr. Cross, Mr. Pentagon, and Dave Diamond were given more comics to shine in. Heather Hexagon also made her debut in page 67 as a possible romantic interest for Triangle Man, which is neat. And Polygoon celebrated its 1-year anniversary. And now, at page 75, we've arrived at our next arc.
Quiet, musical hog, knock it off!
Prison Goons is the third arc of Polygoons, which was likely released sometime between mid-2018 to 2019. The arc stretches from page 75 to page 92, and thankfully most, if not all, of Prison Goons has been archived. Prison Goons tells us the story of Mr. Pentagon's life in prison, which was actually established in his debut comic. We're also reintroduced to Dave Diamond, who becomes Mr. Pentagon's sidekick in escaping the prison. That is, unless Tabitha has something to say about it. Bring out the hijinks. Eventually the two get a one-up on Tabitha, killing her. Which is a natural turn of events, of course. And then we get this moment, where Dave reveals the truth about Triangle Man's party trick. And so, Mr. Pentagon comforts him, empathizing with his lie and revealing his name as Percy Pentagon. The arc continues, with Dave seemingly escaping prison, and leaving behind a cake with, quote-unquote, something that can help him get out of jail. And if you've been paying close enough attention, then you'll know that this works out. And so, Mr. Pentagon is let free. Arc over. Nah, just kidding, we gotta take out Tabitha again. And in a turn of events, a character who was crazy enough to keep dynamite in her pocket wasn't crazy enough to expect that it would be used against her. And so the two make it out alive, which leads to one of the biggest surprises in Polygoon's lore. Gay. And now Percy and Dave can move on in life. Wait, why is he driving a steamroller? Holy shit. This arc is peak Polygoons. It fleshes out two major characters in the Polygoons world, gives us a new villain who raises the stakes, connects the dots between many of the webcomic's first pages and the start of Polygools, and is both entertaining and emotionally engaging. Yeah, I do wish we got a couple more pages in between the death of Tabitha and Dave's confession, or even some more hints at the reveal of Percy's feelings for Dave, but this is easily the best arc in the Polygon series. It's ambitious, tells a well-executed story, and introduces Percy and Dave as main characters, along with Triangle Man and Square Guy, of course. Comics following Prison Goons would continue to be a success. The evolution in character dynamic between Mr. Pentagon and Dave proved to be popular with the new Polygoons fandom. And as we're nearing the 100th comic of Polygoons, things were looking up. Let's see how the webcomic evolves. Pages 100 to 112 of Polygoons are pretty standard for a webcomic. I don't mean that in a judgmental way, of course, but it accomplishes what you'd expect from the start of a series. Wait, haven't I been here before? Page 100 of Polygoons is a redraw of the first comic in the series. At least, it is at a first glance. In reality, page 100 attempts to be a reboot of the first comic, and in turn, the series as a whole. You'd think that after building up the world of Polygoons and its characters for 100 pages straight, that restarting the entire series with a new art style isn't the best way to celebrate. And you'd be right, because man, was this an unpopular decision. After starting to build a sizable fanbase, this was the first time Polygoons really divided the audience. Especially because rebooting the webcomic essentially undoes what new fans came to enjoy Polygoons for. There's not much that's been preserved from the reboot arc of Polygoons, aside from page 99, page 100, and a couple panels from the next arc. Artist Objective is the fourth, or fifth if you count the reboot, arc of Polygoons, which was most likely released in late 2018 or early 2019, judging by when Prison Goons started. This arc was technically unfinished story-wise, but the basic synopsis is that Square Guy invites Triangle Man, Mr. Pentagon, and Dave to his personal art gallery, themed around himself. The few pages of this arc that were complete didn't really follow an overarching story like in Polygoons or Prison Goons. They were more about the different characters reacting to the art gallery. Personality-wise, Mr. Pentagon and Dave are unchanged from their previous iterations, even still being in a relationship, and Square Guy is a lot more full of himself. Triangle Man, on the other hand, is presented a lot more as a main character. He's more sympathetic and much less of a goofball. In fact, there hasn't been a traditional Triangle Man moment since page 100, and page 100 was just a reboot of the first comic, so it appears that Triangle Man is having a bit of an identity crisis. And this actually gets addressed in a comic, which leads us to the last remains of Polygoons. I don't know if I consider this an arc, but consider this post-reboot. I also may struggle to explain what happens here, due to the storyline being incomplete and having panels missing, so bear with me. Triangle Man notices things have been off since the reboot, which gets a reaction from Square Guy, who's actually Triangle Man's future self instead. Triangle Man talks to his future self, and this basically retcons the whole reboot with one exception, the God Sword that caused this whole reboot to happen, which is now impaled in future Triangle Man. Triangle Man is told he has to talk to Infinite, and take the sword with him. Then he fucking dies. But thankfully when things get bad, Square Guy's here, and his character is much closer to his original personality. The two reunite, loot future Triangle Man's body, and go off on the hunt for Infinite. At this point, the archived panels start to feel like jumbled puzzle pieces. I'm not sure what goes where, so I'm unable to make a coherent story. All I know is they eventually meet Infinite, and then there's this literal plot hole, I think. And this is kinda where things end. There was no ending. No planned final comic. The Polygoons account just disappeared, without a trace. Although Polygoons as a webcomic wasn't anywhere near the likes of Shen Comics or Cyanide and Happiness, it's hard to deny that it didn't leave an impact on people. You can see this as early on as the Design a Goon contest, and as late as the reboot arc. If people didn't like Polygoons, then they wouldn't have cared enough to submit drawings for their characters to join the Polygoons cast. And alternatively, if people didn't like Polygoons, then they wouldn't have cared enough about the 100-page series getting rebooted. By the post-reboot arc, the account had amassed nearly 30,000 followers, which is no small feat. Yeah, you can pin that on a couple comics going viral, but that's just a possibility when it comes to posting anything online. All that matters is that fans stuck around, and with each new comic, the fanbase grew. I don't know if I would have considered myself part of the fandom, but I was definitely a fan, and I got to see a lot firsthand. The fan art, the ship art, the memes, the inside jokes, the shitposting, the Triangle Man edit, Flexagon. And you can tell that the creator enjoyed his fanbase too. For example, Polygon's Pizza Day became an inside holiday within the fanbase, and fan-submitted original character Flexagon made his debut appearance in Prison Goons before fucking dying. Polygoons even had its own Redbubble page, selling merch with original designs that get updated fairly often. Mind you, the original creator of Polygoons had just turned 16, in either 2018 or 2019, judging by the art style of this drawing. There's a lot to have accomplished by that age, and having been an artist myself when I was 16, I wouldn't have wanted my art to have stayed the same from there on out, which could explain the whole reboot and the updated art style. It's clear that the creator wanted to start back at square one, but I'd imagine that with the pressure of having a fanbase, things are probably harder to execute. After all, from page one of Polygoons to Prison Goons, change felt more like an evolution of the comic. But later on, change felt more deliberate, and change would continue to happen, from the reboot to artist objective, and into the post-reboot, until things just stopped. Was this the reason behind the disappearance of Polygoons? Well, we don't know for sure. Common belief is that the creator stopped making comics to focus on school, and so they abandoned the project. And although they're okay, they probably wouldn't make any more Polygoons comics. And this is the best explanation we've got. Although this may seem anticlimactic, all we can do is speculate. But at the very least, we can continue to archive old comics, and wish the creator the best. If you were to look up Polygoons on Instagram, you'd most likely be able to dig up some good results, mostly fan art and the occasional edit. Checking accounts takes you to a graveyard of Polygoon shitpost accounts, a couple reboots, and of course, the Polygoons archive, which I've been getting most if not all of my references from. Looking at Polygoons anywhere else leads less results. There's a couple Reddit posts about Polygoons being unfunny that are still up, along with a dead Amino, a dead DeviantArt community, and it's obvious that someone's been fucking with the Polygoons wiki. And whatever you do, don't look up Polygoons on Twitter. Worst mistake of my life. Overall, the Polygoon scene is pretty dormant. And to most people watching, I'm sure you didn't even know a scene for Polygoons even existed. There are sparks of hope for the Polygoons community, such as the archive, any mentions of it past 2019, and lost media enthusiasts. But without word from the creator, we won't know what's in store for the series. Will we ever see Square Guy or Triangle Man again? I don't know. I suppose we'll just have to wait and see.